अगेन गुड मॉर्निंग एंड आई विल क्रिएट वन यूट्यूब चैनल. ओके, सो द रिकॉर्डिंग विल बी देयर इन यूट्यूब चैनल फॉर यू. So let us try to elaborate each and everything. What is failure? So there are inputs, software system, and bugs. Bugs are the codes. And see, input, software system, failure. So different terminologies are there. What are the faults? Okay. Then see, fault, defect, and bug. Some book elaborate fault as different entity. Okay. So I will give you 9 examples. 9 different entities, and based on this you can understand what is bug and what is fault and what is failure. Okay, so we will elaborate each and everything one by one. Yes
sir, abhi bhi syllabus dikh raha hai screen par. So sir, aap jo explain kar rahe ho, mujhe laga tha aap dusre ppt mein explain kar rahe ho.
Oh, correct. I am explaining the PPT and you are unable to see the PPT. Am I correct or not? Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Now, is it visible to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So here you can see there are different terminologies associated with software testing. So these terminologies are very important, and we must know the clear difference between all these things. Otherwise, we won't be able to say anything about this. And these are the terminologies often used by us in different phases of software engineering. Okay. So what is a failure? So failure is the inability of a system or component to perform a required function according to its specification. Okay. Is this very difficult thing, failure? Then fault. What is a fault? Fault or bug, here it is given. Fault is a condition that in actual case actual causes a system to produce failure. It can be said that failure are manifestation of bug. Bahut badhiya, very nice definition is written by the Oxford author. Okay, then come to error. Whenever a member of development team makes any mistake, okay, in any phase of SDLC, that is software development lifecycle, errors are produced. It might be typographical error, a misleading of a specification, misunderstanding of what a sub routine does, and so on. Thus, error is very general term used for human mistake. So we will elaborate all three things one by one. So what is error and what is bug and what is failure? Actually, we are having three different terminologies. So I'm not discussing like this. I'm discussing like bugs, okay, faults, and failures. What are the first thing? Very first terminology, if we consider bug. Bug is like syntax error in code. Okay, if we are talking about the analogy of this, then faults are nothing but program does not work. Okay, program is unable to work and then failures. Failures are, you can say that software installation fails. So this is syntax error in code. This is program does not work and installation fails. Second terminology, in case of bugs, this is improper logic. Bugs are coming due to improper logic. Okay, like greatest among three number or some other kind of things are there. So if we use improper logic, then the outcome of this is, program delivers incorrect result. Okay, program delivers incorrect results. And then what is failure? Failure is software generates misleading results. So it is means thus fails to get accepted. Fine. So this is another thing. Now come to, so if we use improper logic, okay, like one person uses if A is greater than B, okay, if A is greater than C, so printf A is greatest, else B is greatest, else C is greatest. Okay, so this is incorrect logic. Actually, we have checked for A whether A is greater than B and A is greater than C or not. And then we have generated two different else. Okay, first else is associated with A is greater than C, and next else is associated with A is greater than B. You can clearly see that if we use else of this branch, else of this branch, so C will never come. Okay, so this is improper logic. So you must, and it will deliver the incorrect result. Maybe due to this, if we are not using proper curly braces, like this curly brace is used and this curly brace is used, then it is good. If we are not using curly braces, then it will generate bugs also. Okay, it will give you syntax error also sometimes. So it depends how do you perform your program and how do you write your code. And because you have also heard about and you have done COCOMO, okay, cost construction model, 10 kilo lines of codes, okay. So how do we identify error in which portion and which two is logical, because it is not generating any compile time error, but logical error is generated. So that is the important thing. How do we fix bugs? Okay, when Windows 98 was there in cell, okay, so around 2 lakh bugs are there, okay, and in Windows XP, maybe this is statistics is wrong, but very huge number of bugs are there. If we run particular program, it says something else. If we close something, so it will close some other thing. So that's why, and around 20,000 bugs are there in Windows XP. And even in Windows 10, so many bugs are there. You have heard about the previous, that update was 2004, okay? April 20 update. In this April 20 update, what happened? System slows down, okay? And memory consumption is very high, okay? Memory consumption is very high. It simply means that because the person who is using SSD hard disk nowadays, SSD, okay, so with SSD we are having very limited capacity, like someone is having 256 GB and some having 512 GB. So with this, if it uses a huge amount of memory, like in my system, what happens, it shows me 370 GB consumed. Okay, so this was very big amount, not 370, it is 410 GB. So only 60 GB was remaining there. And after this update after this bug fixes was done, then it is now coming to 360 GB. So this is very important thing, bug fixes, and these are the part of life cycle. Now come to third terminology, improper understanding of requirement. Okay, bugs, improper understanding of requirements. So listening is very good thing and it is one art. What happened, the customers are coming to you and they are they will narrate the story, how do we create the software, and we try to understand the whatever he or she is delivering, and based on our understanding we will create some other thing. Okay, yes, this may, yes, we have already done, yes, so many yes, we will put there. And ultimately what happened, the customer wants this thing. You have seen the diagram in system analysis program, custom wants this thing. Okay, what I understand is something else, and what I deliver is, just see, what I understand is, okay, and what I delivered is fine. This is my understanding, this is available with customer, this is available with customer, and what I delivered is different thing, and sometimes this is different thing. So that is very important. Okay, so try to understand, and careful listening is very important. Listeners are very important during software engineering development of any software product. So due to this, what faults may occur? Program, it is very simple thing. If we are not able to understand the requirement, so programs are not written as per requirement. Fine. And what are the failures? Failures may be customer refuse to accept. The software enhance, it fails to deliver. Fine. So this is very, very important thing. And this will, if customer totally destroy the contract, okay. So SRS, you have heard about software requirement specification and software requirement documentation. So this is very important thing. What you have understand, what customer has narrated, both will match, and we will sign, the customer will sign that document, and the team manager will sign the document, and the team, entire team, okay, team leader also signed the document, and based on this specification we will provide the output. Then come to fourth step, incorrect system design. Bug is इनकरेक्ट सिस्टम डिजाइन, so what is incorrect system design even though requirement have understood, okay, so what kind of problem may occur? So failure of this kind, system does not function as per the requirement. Very clear thing, system does not function as per requirements, okay, and we can say like a flow of event is wrong. Or flow of event is wrong, or duplication of data at the duplication of the data at the entry level. Or unwanted data. Unwanted data capturing is made mandatory. Okay, so there are varieties of example related with this. So like sometimes what happened, the form will collect unnecessary data, like what is your favorite color. So how favorite color is associated with movie ticket? If I want to see the movie, online movies, okay, so how, why should I write my favorite color or my favorite food? So these are the some unwanted thing. So this may happen. Software does not function as per requirement, even though we will provide the everything is provided clearly. So bugs are incorrect system design, although requirement have understood clearly, but the flow of event like this, if a is greater than b, okay, so it is often confusing while writing, but it is very important thing. This is in design phase, okay, and this is in the requirement SRS phase. So now what kind of failure will be there? So again, if it is not working properly, then why should customer purchase this? So failure is customer refuse to accept the system. Okay, so this is one more drawback of this incorrect system design. Now come to fifth thing. Fifth associated bug is incorrect implementation. Design is incorrect, okay, understanding is incorrect, design is incorrect. Now this is our turn to incorrect implementation method. You have chosen one database, okay, you are having a tremendous set of database, so you have chosen NoSQL instead of SQL. You have chosen NoSQL, and because the system is traditional, it wants a SQL kind of data set, database. Then how do the system will perform, because the range of system are very old to new? So how do the system will perform? So that may be a problem. Although you have created each and everything very good as per today's standard, but because of incorrect implementation method, it will generate faults. So the fault may be delay in implementation. Not using proper implementation method. And or you can say, or technical faults are seen at various phases or modules. Or lack of skilled resources either at one end or both the ends. Okay, so this is very important thing. See, we have implemented some system where it is required to have a skilled person at the user end or at the software development end also, because this is constant thing. We are not using Word kind of software where Word is fixed. Okay, whatever delivered by Microsoft, we need to accept it as it is. But like software as a examination system, okay, online examination system. So there are changes, there are requirement of changes. So for those changes, one person is there at the software designing end, and another person like we, the users, are at the at the user level or nav user end. So we must know what is the password, how do we change the subject code, how do we change the writing type of assignment, or how do we generate the quiz. All these things we must know. But if the person who is unaware of all these things, then it will also create some distraction. So what failure may be there due to this? See, delay in implementation is a special kind of thing. Like if you have given requirement in case of SQL, I had told you no SQL, but now suppose if the requirement is given in SQL, but nowadays no SQL is there. So how do we implement? And the person has implemented in SQL, and we have purchased all the systems related with no SQL. We have purchased the server related with no SQL. Then how do we migrate this data from this data? This is also very big problem. So to avoid this thing, we must produce our software within stipulated time, or we need to ask the customer that this much delay is there. And nowadays, the technology lies in this particular phase. So do you agree to accept new technology and then develop the product according to this? Failure. Delay in implementation loses its importance, okay? It loses its importance. Second thing is, and morale of team enhance fails, fault occurring at any phases or modules, off system tends to lose the capability or no, capability is good thing, the credibility of system. Okay, very important thing, the credibility of system, lose the credibility. Of the system. Okay, now come to this was fifth. Sixth thing is only two or three more there. So let us discuss wrong assessment of system or data load. This may also happen. So what is a bug? Wrong assessment of system or data load. Okay, so what are the problems associated with this? Fault may like system response is poor in the case of large volume of data. Second thing is or number of users. Okay, number of large volume of data or number of users. If it is incremented, fine. Increase in number of users accessing the system. So due to what is the actually what kind of thing is associated with this? So this is incompatibility of hardware and software. You are having some idea about this Big Sur, Apple's operating system, and Big Sur or Big Sur, and second one is Mojave. Okay, so Mojave is working finely, and as soon as we update the system, it will automatically degrade the performance. So whatever Apple's policy is not very fair actually. So due to that, sometime it may happen. Now come to what kind of failures are there. So poor response result in reluctance to use the system, correct or not? Poor response result in reluctance to use the system. Like this is the case of Microsoft Teams. We are using Microsoft Teams, and certainly what happened, my hardware is not capable of handling the bandwidth of this much kind. So automatically the system will lose its performance and my voice will lag to your end, and you will automatically lose the attention from my delivery. So this is also one of the biggest disadvantage of wrong assessment of system or data load. Okay, so this may include hardware, software, and number of people or concurrency. Fine. Now come to seventh thing. Seventh thing is documentation is not proper. This is our bug. Documentation is not proper. This could be user system. This could be user or system documentation. Fine. And the fault associated with this, you know very well that operating instruction mentioned in the documentation manuals are not mentioned properly. Okay. SOP is not mentioned properly. What is SOP? Anyone? Yes. Anybody is there or not?
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes, yes. What is SOP?
Yes, sir.
It is a standard operating procedure.
Operating procedure, sir.
Fine. So this is not mentioned properly. So due to this, the problem may occur. Then technical manuals have not enough or relevant documentation. So this is another thing. Technical manuals not enough and relevant documentation. Okay, so we are reaching up to documentation phase from understanding, design, implementation, assessment, and documentation. Now, 8th and 9th phase, I'm just writing the, just giving the failure of this 7 phases. Documentation is not proper. So the user is not able to run the system as manual contains erroneous or insufficient data instruction. Actually, it is not saying that how do we, it will say that open the file and all other things, but it is not sufficient, insufficient data instruction. So failure is user is not able to run the system. The user is not able to run the system. Fine. Now come to 8th thing. 8th thing is associated with incorrect master data given or uploading of erroneous input data. So incorrect master data, like in first year, your data may be incorrectly uploaded by the system, or erroneous input data. So this is our bug. The fault is associated with this is picked up the wrong data for execution. Picked up the wrong data for execution. Actually, in physics experimentation, we are going to use acceleration due to gravity, that is 9.8. Okay. And we have used gravitational constant because the software developer don't know the difference between small g and capital G. So this is 6.64 into 10 to the power minus 34, just for an example. So if you see the quantity, very huge difference is there, and that's why the answer will be wrong. Okay, so this is very important thing. And The failure is results may incorrect due to data issue. Fine. And finally, the ninth point is system security is not means it is system bug is system security is not proper or not thought or has poor security or poor system security is very good thing. Then the fault associated with this is, it is very simple thing. It is open for all. Like we have used port number 22, 23, 27. These are the vulnerable ports. Okay. One can open these ports and can access your document. And after accessing your document, he or she can delete or modify the content. So open to all means open to all. And due to this, what failures may occur? As the system is not secured enough, customers are reluctant. Okay. Again, reluctant. Customers are reluctant. Like WhatsApp. I'm saying that please switch yourself from WhatsApp to Signal. Why? Because I feel that WhatsApp will violate all the rules and regulations because it has only able to run in my system when I provide all the things. Okay, so that is the important thing, and WhatsApp will share my data also without any loss of generality, but it gives me a tremendous loss. Okay, so these are the 9 issues we have discussed. So with this, we finish today's class. If you have any doubt, you can ask. So today we have concluded the difference between bugs, faults, and failures. Okay. So tomorrow we will perform some other thing. So thank you very much for today's class. Have a nice day. Have a nice time.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.